Hello guys, so this is going to be about comparing the 26650 lithium ion batteries. Okay, this is my flashlight, really nice husky heavy duty flashlight that I converted to 3 26650 cell, and it's running on 1 Cree XHP 70, and pretty much it gets a lot of light. We're not gonna go into that right now, but let's go into the driver. Okay, the driver, now this is giving me pretty much 12 volts with 3 cells. Okay, so at 12 volts the driver on a high mode will run on 5.6 amps and 6.4 volts. Okay, and I don't have the heatsink done correctly to properly dissolve the heat on this thing, so I can run it on a high mode for about couple of minutes, but then I am just running into the problem here that I could possibly burn the LED. But I've been running this for about right now for about roughly four and a half hours on the second mode, and that is 1.8 amps. Okay, so at 12 volts this driver will give me 1.8 amps divided to 3 batteries. It's going to give me roughly about 0.6 amps for each. Okay, well, the point is I got 3 different batteries here, and let's open it up. What I got is the PKCELL, which is considered a decent battery, and it's 5000 milliamp hours. Okay, I don't know if you can read it, but I can read it for you if you don't mind. So that's a PKCELL 26650. Then we've got the OLIGHT 26650, and that's rated to 4500 milliamp hours. Okay, so this one is a little bit lower than the PKCELL. And then we've got the EBL, and again this is rated 5000 milliamp hours. So let me tell you this much, when I throw it on the charger, which is this beautiful charger here, and it runs actually really nice, and it will tell me how many milliamps is feeding the battery. Okay, now I'm feeding the 18650, but anyway, on those I charge them fully before I start this test, and they pretty much performed very equally. Okay, this EBL actually charged roughly about 5100 milliamp hours. Let's put it this way, I discharged them to 2.8-2.9 volts, or roughly in that area, all of them, and they all of them charged pretty much the same way. They charged roughly around 5000. Okay, this one was a little bit less, the OLIGHT, but this one actually performed the best. This one was a little bit below 5000. The PKCELL was about maybe 4600 or so. didn't make a note, but if I remember correctly, this one was about right on the mark, 45 or 46 milliamp hours, and this one was about 51 and some change. So this one actually seems like would be the best of all of these, right? According to the charger. But how do they perform when you're discharging them? So I feed them to this flashlight in series, and they will discharge. They will discharge equally. And I discharge them for about, like I said, 4 hours, maybe 4.5 hours at 1.8 amps. That means 0.6 amps each. Okay. Now let's see which one will perform the best at the end of discharging, or which one has actually the most capacity of all of these. Okay, so I will zoom on the meter here. I think you can read the numbers. I would think so. Yep. Now let's get to the test. So let's start with the EBL. Why not? This is the cheapest one. It's about, I got 4 of these for $20 on eBay. And I think those are actually pretty good batteries. I already tested them before a little bit. So this one is at 3.440 volts right now. So let's get the OLIGHT. And that's gonna be a little bit difficult because it has the little thing here at the bottom, whatever, that's okay. And this one is 3.448. 449. So this one is actually better off. The OLIGHT, okay. And the PKCELL? 3.389. So they are very compatible. But this is interesting. The PKCELL, I think I got 2 of these for $20 on eBay. Okay, the PKCELL. I got 4 of these for $20 on eBay. And this, I don't remember, but the OLIGHT, you can check for yourself. I can't remember. It wasn't cheap. So let's do this one again. 3.440. So that is actually really, really good for this EBL battery for the price. And I tested them before, and I just couldn't really believe how well they perform. But let me do this again all over. $3.449, and the PKCELL $3.39. Yep. So, I mean, don't get me wrong, the PKCELL is still a good battery, but if I would choose between this and that, and again, I don't know how long they're gonna last, okay? How many charges they will take, that's up in the air, I don't know that. But the performance of EBL is just amazing for that price. You know, 20 bucks for four of these. I gotta give these guys a plug, okay? Those are not bad batteries. Even the 18650, that's actually how I started first on these. I got a couple of these at 18650, and I tested them, and they performed actually very well. And that's why I decided to get maybe about six of these EBL, and I actually ordered another four recently. But they are good batteries. I mean, I don't know how long they're gonna last, but I gotta say they perform very well. Okay, and even when they discharge in a high rate, like on that 6 amps that I have on this driver, they don't get hot. Let's put it that way. So they are good. Okay. Next time.